How did you, at the time, especially when you really had nothing at the time, how did you keep going? Or were there times that you didn't want to keep going?
Yeah, of course there were times I didn't want to keep going. I actually had a shotgun and took it out to kill myself one night. Mm-hmm. And I still remember that moment. I still remember the night. I remember the gun. I remember I had two shells. I fired the first one to see that the gun actually worked. Mm-hmm. And the second one was to be aimed at me. And I paused because I thought, well, what if all this changes? What if next week or next month or next year I get published? What if it starts to move for me? And I end it all now. And so I stopped because of curiosity, and thank God, because I've had a life, I've had decades of success I never would have imagined or dreamed possible on a scale that I never even was going for. It's beyond what I was dreaming, and I almost ended it. How did I keep going? You know, I said I lived in the public library, and I did. And so in the public library, I parked myself in the self-development, success, philosophy, metaphysics area, and I devoured all the books: The Think and Grow Rich, The Magic of Believing, How to Win Friends and Influence People, the great success literature of all time, Psycho-Cybernetics in the 60s. And I kept reading those books. Now, remember, I have no coach, I have no mentor, I have no friend, I have no relationship. It is me, my books, and the public library.
Yeah.
I kept reading those books, and I kept applying to the best of my ability what I was reading.
Yeah.
And it was because of that self-help material. People have often asked me today, how did I get into self-help? It's like, because I needed help. I was the first person that needed help. It was me. I needed help. I needed hope. I needed to know it was possible. And these books reminded me. I read biographies, and I saw that a lot of people struggle. Some of the most successful people of all time did not get born with a golden spoon.
Right.
They struggled. They starved. They went through desperate times.
Yes.
And so did I.
Yeah.
But by reading their stories and their biographies, I thought, maybe there's a chance. Maybe there's a chance for me if they did it. And I'm human. I've got arms and hands and brains and, you know, all of that. I can try too. So it was the books that kept me going. I kept getting hope. And of course, there were dark nights that I didn't think I'd get through.